Yeah, there was a numbers game, and the numbers game mattered because of its symbolism. So Lee moves quickly to establish that the odds he had faced in the end had been insurmountable. And he writes Jefferson Davis and says he was outnumbered 5-1 in the end, and that he had sort of 8,000 effectives, men who were in shape to fight there on that last morning of April 9th, that attempt to punch a hole in the Union defenses. Scholars, historians at the National Battlefield Park and others have sort of gathered together all the existing returns and found that in the end, Lee faced odds of 2-1. There were roughly 60,000 Union men and 30,000 Confederates in the vicinity of Appomattox
in that
last day. Not 5-1. But Confederates, not only Lee, once the news of the surrender sort of travels over the wires and reaches southern communities, cities and farms and so on, Confederates show this same propensity to inflate the size of the federal army. So what Lee had said were odds of 5-1 in accounts, Confederate diaries and letters become odds of 10-1 and 50-1 and 100-1 and so on, propensity to inflate the size of the Confederate army. Again, on some level, and understandably so, because the Union army seemed sort of all-encompassing and endless in the eyes of in the eyes of Confederates. There was an awkward sort of element to all of this in the sense that there is a surrender ceremony, a stacking of the arms that takes place on April 12th. And lo and behold, more than 23,000 Confederates stack arms and receive paroles, the certificates vouching that they had been part of this final agreement, more than the 8,000 effectives that Lee claimed that he had. And Lee tries, and his men who rally around him, Lee's inner circle, his lieutenants, his right-hand men, really rally around this overwhelming numbers and resources argument. Again, the point of it being there can be no shame in such a defeat, to have lost to such odds. And they will in their post-war writings, engage in this inflation of numbers, and they'll explain the discrepancy between the number of men who were effectives and the number of men who were in the surrender ceremony and who were paroled, by saying that there had been men sort of detailed to the back of the army. There had been some stragglers and some deserters, that those 8,000 represent the kind of beating heart of the Confederate Army, the core of the cause, the core heroes of the cause, and that those, Lee will in essence make the argument that those men who had been present for duty in the final hour represented the very virtues which needed to be restored to national life, that his army and not Grant's represented the constancy and devotion and steadfastness that Lee associated with the halcyon days of the early republic and that needed to be restored to national life if the peace was going to take and be a just peace.